Hey guys, I just edited this video and I completely forgot to let you know that I have a Twitter now. I'm gonna be super active on there. Feel free to follow me, message me, all that good stuff. Looking forward to seeing you guys there. My top 10 favorite Lightning players of franchise history, whenever, wherever. Why did I say it like that? Let's get the list started. In the number 10 spot, we have my boy, Brian Boyle. Now, any Lightning fans watching this should not be surprised by Mr. Brian Boyle being in my top 10 favorites. He was on the team from 2014 to 2017. There was a lot of really good runs within that time span on the Lightning. Of course, we all know this team loves to choke. So it's unfortunate he wasn't able to get the ring while he was on the team. Stand up, class act. You know, he was recently diagnosed with cancer and he kicked it in the butt. We love you for that, Brian. You're a boss. As soon as he left, it was rough. It was. He was such a fan favorite, and there's a reason why. You know, even Rangers fans can attest to this. He's a great guy, great player. Nothing bad to say. In the number 9 spot, we have Ruslan Fedotenko. Now, this player specifically, and there's going to be someone else higher in the list, I did not get the privilege of seeing in person, not in memory. I was born and raised in Tampa. I was raised going to Lightning games and stuff like that. But quite honestly, my memory is trash. So a lot of the games that I went to when I was much younger, don't remember a lot of, unfortunately. But Ruslan Fedotenko, just, I remember, it just repeats in my mind all the time. Not all the time, but when I'm feeling nostalgic of the Lightning, Fedotenko, that name just rings over and over and over and over. Again, if you're a Lightning fan, you know how pivotal he was to win the 2004 Stanley Cup. The Lightning got underrated in his time with the Lightning. Number 8 on the list is Vincent LeCavalier. I enjoyed him. I loved him. He was a great captain, great skilled player, another player that helped win the cup back in 2004. Definitely miss seeing him play. It was rough, especially seeing him in another jersey towards the end of his career. You know, he just another class act. You know, he did so much for the Tampa community, and he's missed for sure. Number 7 is Mr. Andre Vasilevsky. There doesn't really need to be explanation for a lot of these players towards the top of the list, but I'm gonna do them some justice just cuz they should receive, you know, the praise that they do. You know, when Vasilevsky was being brought up in the system, the Lightning system, and he had so much potential to his name and he was backing up Ben Bishop, I really think having Ben Bishop as a mentor is what really helped propel his career in the direction that it's going now. You know, he's arguably one of the best goaltenders in the league. You'd be hard pressed to find someone that actually says that he isn't, you know, one of the best in the league. And as I say, and it's kind of cringe, he's one of those players that is eye candy in terms of just how he plays, the things that he does game in, game out. He's able to just take control of games and do it with ease sometimes. And he's the kind of goalie that you need for deep runs, for sure. And that'll get you there and win you a cup. Unfortunately, that hasn't happened yet. We're hoping, obviously, it does. In the number 6 spot, I have none other than Ben Bishop. He was the guy there for a while. He was just fantastic. Unfortunately, injury problems. Stars fans can definitely understand this too. He is injury prone, but when he's on, he is on. He's one of the best goalies in the league when he is. Now, number 5 on the list is Victor Hedman. Again, one of those players that doesn't really need explanation. Been one of the best defensemen, if not the best defenseman in the league now for a while. You know, he's a favorite player of many people for a reason. His offensive game, his defensive game, he's what you want in a franchise defenseman. Really all you have to say about him, I mean, his play speaks for himself. Now, number 4 on the list is Nikita Kucherov. What a player. He started off in his first year with 18 points. I remember distinctly him being very frustrated with himself, that he knew that there was potential in him and he could do so much better after that rookie year of his. And he beat himself up during that offseason, and he comes back the season after and gets 60 something points, and we're just like, okay, we see you, Cooch. And of course, you know, the dominant season that he had last year, and when he continues to do now, just a treat to watch and to be a fan of, and to be able to have a player like this on your team is, you know, you're grateful. You just are. Number three is Martin St. Louis. I would argue probably the heart and the soul of the Lightning team for a while. You know, it did hurt when he went to the Rangers. It really did. I can't sit here and say that it didn't. He is sorely missed. You know, you'd be hard-pressed to find any kind of Lightning fan now that's really salty anymore about that whole Rangers situation years ago. Just another class act, fantastic player, another key role in the 2004 Stanley Cup. Number two is Dan. Now, in a list that we have currently, you may be wondering, okay, Dan Boyle? Why is Dan Boyle on this list? You know, you're talking about all these other fantastic players, elite level players on this list of mine, and there's Dan Boyle. Dan Boyle single-handedly really was the catalyst to my hockey fandom. I remember distinctly back in 2004, the Cup run. I don't really remember a whole lot from that 2004 run. I was only, what, 7 years old? But I remember just how dominant he was that entire year, thinking, wow, who is this guy? What is this sport? What do I do with this? You know, everyone has that certain player, I would say, that really, you know, attracted their eyes at a young age, and it brought them to be a fan of the sport. And Dan Boyle was just that, simply. I remember him going to the Sharks after and becoming a Sharks fan for a little bit there when he was on the Sharks. Crazy enough, he was that much of a motivation and role in my hockey fandom, for sure. And I miss him for sure. You know, all the players that are retired here on this list, I miss him. I do. You know, you grow up watching these players, they retire, and it never gets easy when they retire. I just realized, and I can't believe I did this, I left Braden Point out of this list. I would, before we get to my favorite player of all time, I would definitely place Braden Point at number 8 on the list. The more and more he continues to play year after year, I have no doubt in my mind in a couple years or so, he's going to be in the top 3 easily. So just imagine Braden Point is 8 and the other players were moved down. My number one favorite player of all time, if anyone knows me in real life and has been friends for any set of amount of time, you know this is going to be Steven Stamkos. He is the guy. You know, he, after Dan Boyle retired, he was the guy for me. He's done so much for the Tampa community, being raised in Tampa and just seeing the impact of these players doing wonders in my community, including him. He was the role model for, I would even say he's still a role model to me. Just his work ethic, him as a person, he's everything that you want in a player. You might get that, hey, look, this is awful cliche to have Steven Stamkos, or there's people that say that Kucherov are their favorite players, and you might say that that's cliche, but look, to me, it really doesn't matter. People have their own reasonings to why they're your favorite. If look, you want to say that your favorite player is one of the best in the league, such as like Kucherov, and he's your favorite player, then so be it. You know, strut it. You know, say that he's your favorite player and don't be ashamed of it. Anyways, I got a little sidetracked there, but Steven Stamkos, for sure, that's never going to change, no matter the circumstance. I just don't see him not being my favorite player of all time. Something drastic would have to happen in order for that to change. Next list that I do for favorite players, I ensure I will be much more prepared and make sure that there's no missing players. That is, again, my apology. If you guys got any suggestions of any kind, please just drop it in the comment section below. I'll consider it for, you know, a future video. Thank you guys so much for watching. This recent growth has just been crazy. I never would have imagined this early on, or even ever, that this would happen. It just kind of came out of nowhere. During the entire process, I was freaking out, like, just talking to friends, like, yo, is this really happening right now? They're like, yes, Logan, this is really happening. And I just want to thank you guys, seriously, especially all you Islanders fans that have been just really kind to me and just fantastic in the comment section. You guys are awesome, and I'm not gonna forget about you Lightning fans. Love you guys as well. Anyways, enough of the sap story. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will be seeing you in a future video, and take care.